Good evening and welcome to Communities at Work, a monthly program at BCTV bringing to you issues that are affecting our community. I am your host this evening, Yvonne Stroman, Director of Community Programs at Community Prevention Partnership. Tonight's topic, we will be discussing youth and gangs. Tonight, we're going to do something a little different. I'm going to bring to you a PowerPoint presentation recognizing issues that are affecting youth, more specifically gangs in our community, more specifically about prevention and what you as a home viewer, as a parent, as a concerned citizen can do to prevent youth to become from involving themselves in gangs. We'll also bring to you some warning signs and some indicators that might give you an indication that youth are becoming involved in gangs. And why we are bringing this to you tonight. In 2006, the U.S. Attorney General's Office, in cooperation with the City of Reading, as well as some other cities that are along the 222 corridor, had been given some federal funding to address youth and their involvement in gangs, and more specifically, some prevention efforts. So we're going to have this PowerPoint presentation, but that should not prohibit you from calling us in if you have any questions. The number tonight is 610-378-0426. If you as a home viewer have more specific questions relative to our PowerPoint this evening. So here we go. Gangs and youth and what you need to know. The objectives for tonight is to increase your knowledge of youth and the behaviors that youth engage in, increase your awareness of gangs in the city of Reading and Berks County, be able to identify current youth risk trends, what puts youth at risk to participate in gang activity, your ability to recognize the potential at-risk behaviors among youth, and to increase your knowledge about community resources. Want to bring to you tonight knowledge that youth is not anything new to the United States or the state of Pennsylvania or even the county of Berks. As you can see upon the screen, gangs have been documented in nearly every state. National Drug Intelligence Center reports that there are over 7,400 individual gang sets that are identified in the United States. Folk and People Nations are in 35 states. Crips and Bloods are in 42 states. We have white gangs in 44 states. Latino Hispanic gangs are in 41 states, as well as Asian gangs in 41 states. Now I want to get to you some information that youth are reporting to us, and this is countywide. In 2007, a gang prevention survey revealed that 14% of youth reported being in a gang at some point in time. Know that boys are more likely than girls to be involved in gangs. The average age of first involvement is 13 to 14 years of age. 65% of the students surveyed said that they know a gang member that's attending their school. And youth who reported being in a gang reported that they are twice as likely not feeling safe at school. So how do we define a gang? Sometimes people think that if there are three or five youth that are gathered on a corner and they're all dressed in jeans and white sneakers and a white t-shirt, that they must be involved in some gang of some sort. Well, that's not necessarily true. By definition, a gang is defined as a group of three or more individuals who participate in some kind of illegal activity. So usually when you think about gangs, you think of folks that dress in the same colors. Maybe they have the same kind of hat that they're wearing, and know that without the form of criminal activity, they could be involved in a gang such as sports. You know, all people who, you know, there are times sometimes when you think of football teams are considered to be a gang. Police officers may even be considered a gang, but what differentiates those people from gangs is the illegal activity. And it usually involves violent crime, drug dealing, or both. Now, a street gang is an organized group that participates in criminal, threatening, or intimidating activity within the community. Gangs usually have a name, and there's usually a leadership, and they usually have identifying signs, colors, clothing, tattoos, jewelry, or hand signals. And the gang often claims a geographic territory. As I mentioned earlier, boys usually more than girls are involved in a gang, but know that there are girls in gangs too. There are an estimated 1 million gang members in America, and one-third of them are girls. Girls do form their own gangs and also belong to spin-off of guy gangs. The girl gangsters can be just as dangerous and just as organized. They are also intimidated in the same manner in boys. Please note that oftentimes when folks want to belong to a gang, they do so out of the need for security and safety. Also, just so that you know, that there are various forms of which people can belong in gangs. Sometimes they're being beaten into a gang, or sometimes in terms of girls, they're being sexed into a gang, which means, tragically, that a girl wishes to belong into the gang, they must have sex with all those gang members. So these are some things that put youth at risk that can be troubling for them if they wish to belong in gangs. While yes, they may want to feel like they're belonging to something that is positive in nature, but know that gangs usually don't indicate anything that are positive worthy, if you will. So let's talk about why other reasons that youth might join in gangs. And as you can see, there's some pictures here. You can see a little boy, looked to be about 9 or 10 years old. He has a red handkerchief. He's using some gang signs. And at the bottom, there's a group of folks, and they're all holding up gang signs. But what's more troubling is that there are young people as young as 3, 4, maybe 5 years old that they're being taught gang signs early on. So why youth join gangs? Sometimes they're born into it. They don't have a choice about it. They may have a father or mother who belongs in the gang, and so just by virtue of being born into it, they belong in that gang. Why else white youth might join in gangs is because it's become a neighborhood norm. A neighborhood norm might mean this: if you're going to belong in this neighborhood, you need to belong in this gang for protection. Some youth might join gangs because of power, protection, prestige, and they think that it's a party time to belong in a gang. And some youth may belong into a gang because they feel as though that gang is meeting its basic need to belong, its basic need for protection, its basic need for love. Some folks might belong into a gang for money and because they feel it's a cool factor. So there are a number of reasons why young people might join gangs. And those are the reasons they feel as though it's necessary for them to belong in gangs. But know that there are consequences associated to belonging in gangs. As I tell young people, it's easy to get into a gang maybe, but it's difficult to get out. Sometimes you'll hear, once in a gang, always in a gang. And if you want to leave our gang, the same way that you came into that gang might be a way that you have to leave it. So if you were beaten into a gang, guess what? There are times that you might have to be beaten out of the gang or, unfortunately, even killed. So those are some of the negative consequences. Let's move on. What puts youth at risk to belong in gang? What are some of the youth risk behaviors, some indicators that youth are involved in gangs? There's some sudden alcohol, tobacco, and other drug use. Maybe there's an onset of violence and aggression. There might be some bullying that's going on. Maybe some increase in sexual activities. Or suddenly there's some weapons that kids are using. Or there might be some acts of prejudice and hate. And again, some of these things could be some youth risk behaviors that put youth at risk to belong in gangs. There might be some youth involvement indicators in the neighborhood. As you can see in some of these slides that I'm showing the home viewers are some local gang graffiti or some local signs that have been postured around the city and even the greater Reading area. And so there might be some verbal indicators that your young person is involved in a gang because he or she admits to being in it. There might be some city, neighborhood, street areas whereby you might see there's some indicator that there's some gang activity, such as on the screen there where it says the Hudson Street Crew, or HSC, which stands for Hudson Street Crew. That might be an indicator that there's some activity going on. When young people have a shout out, they might say they represent a certain area. Or there might be some challenges from another gang member coming in. What set are you from or what gang are you from? Usually that's an indicator that that individual is challenging another gang member. Or there may be some use of gang slang. Those are some gang involvement indicators that might indicate to you as an adult that this young person is involved in a gang. Again, there are some gang involvement indicators such as tattoos, some branding, burning or scarring, graffiti, hand signs, some whistle outs, and some attire. And again, if you look at the PowerPoint slide, there are some indicators that you see a fellow that is actually using some hand signs. You see another one, his face is not only graffiti, but he's also using hand signs. And then this is a picture of a local young teen who's a member of a Latin King, and that he's displaying his gang affiliation through burning on his hand that he's involved with the Latin Kings. Do have some other indicators through just some of the other graffiti that might have been indicated in your neighborhood. So what I would encourage you to do is, if there's any of this that you see in your neighborhood, is to really contact the police. There is a graffiti abatement removal team that will come out into your area and get rid of that graffiti, and we encourage you to do that as soon as possible. What we're seeing is that the earlier that you can get rid of it, the less likely that folks are coming back out and putting up those graffiti signs to indicate that there's a gang in your neighborhood. Let's move on. There might be some other warning signs, such as backpack or notebooks whereby there's some graffiti on the backpack or notebooks. Might be some inappropriate language, some inappropriate drawings, and maybe some pictures of friends that you don't know. We encourage parents to really get to know who your child's friends are, where they hang out, and also if there's a development of a violent or aggressive attitude. Again, the picture that's being displayed to you is one that was taken from the local law enforcement, from a youth attending one of our local schools. And he's sporting red ink, blood in and blood out. That's usually an indication that they have joined a gang, and that in order to be in that gang, they've had to shed some blood. But in order to get out of that gang, he or she has to shed some blood as well. Maybe there's some language changes in your young person. And there are some, all of a sudden, some new friends. These are some warning signs that perhaps your young person is involved in a gang. Maybe they're starting to use a nickname. Suddenly there's a loss of self-identity. Maybe there's a change in he or she's dress of clothing. Maybe there's some secrecy. Now all of a sudden your young person is now behind closed doors, and you find that they're locking their doors in their bedroom. Or there's some unexplained money, jewelry, or other items that they can't explain. That might be an indication that he or she is involved in gang activity. Perhaps there's some unexplained cuts or bruises. As I mentioned before, sometimes gang members have to fight their way in to belong in a gang. That's what an indication of how tough are you. So they have to fight every member in that gang for a period of time. So there's some unexplained cuts and bruises. Maybe some observed practicing behavior. Now they're in a mirror practicing some hand signs. Or you're seeing some tattoos all of a sudden on their body. Or there's some graffiti that's on their notebooks or in your immediate neighborhood. Suddenly your young person is using some spray cans, markers, etching tools to graffiti some of the territory. That could be some warning signs that that young person might become involved in gangs or is involved in gangs. Maybe there's some graffiti or symbols found around the house, some unusual paraphernalia for drug use and weapons. Again, those could be some warning signs that the young person is involved in gangs. Suddenly, there's some gang paraphernalia. Suddenly, he or she is listening to music, also known as gangster rap or even hate music, or some music that indicates drugs and suicide. There's also on their computer some history of visiting gang websites, hate websites, drug websites, violent websites. Those could be some indicators that your young person is suddenly getting involved in gangs or even intrigued about gangs. Suddenly, he or she has a loss of interest in normal areas where they once were very much involved in. Maybe your young person was once very active in the music program in school, or they were once actively involved in some extracurricular activities in school, and now all of a sudden there's a loss of interest in those areas. That could be an indication that there's some sudden change in behavior and they're involved in gangs. Maybe there's some now problems with school attendance or dropping grades. Those might be some warning signs that your young person is involved in gangs. So we want to encourage young family members to begin those dialogues with addressing some of these warning signs. So after all of that, and know that there's no one indicator, there's no one single indicator that states that your young person might be involved in gangs, but maybe there are several indicators. And as a result of that, what can you do about it? What can you do as a parent or guardian, or even a teacher or school administrator, to address this young person's involvement in gangs? We have a resiliency up here because these resiliency areas indicate that these are some of the things that you could begin to look at to indicate that to address youth involvement in gangs. And so increase pro-social bonding. Research indicates that young people who are invested in pro-social activities or pro-social bonding are less likely to become involved in gangs. Set clear, consistent boundaries. Teach life skills. Provide a support and caring environment. Set and communicate high expectations. Provide opportunities for meaningful participation in activities. And awareness is the first sign. Know what is involved in a gang. Acknowledge that gangs do exist. Be able to identify gang symbols and other identifiers, and know why and how youth can involve themselves in gangs. Know the times have changed. Our music isn't the same as it was when we were growing up. Movies have changed, magazines have changed, and also now there is the new technology age known as the internet. There's MySpace, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, etc., that your young person gets involved with. Know what your child is getting into. Also, there are video games. There are some video games out there that really address youth and their aggression and their violence, which can be indicative of gang activity. There is a genre of different types of drugs that young people are now getting involved with. There's also bullying and violence that young people are getting attracted to. And these could be some indicators, again, that your young person is getting involved in some unhealthy behaviors. And peers play an important role in your child's development. Gangs equal greater chance of violence and drugs. So know who your peers are associating with. Know who your child is associating with in the community. The anti-gang self-concept speaks to do not allowing them to write gang names, initials, symbols, or graffiti in your schools or in your neighborhoods. Do not allow them to use gang-type nicknames in the classroom or in the homes. And do not allow them to flash hand signs in the communities, in the schools, or in the homes. Establish a drug-free and gang-free school zone. Let students know that school is a drug-free zone, as is the community. Do not allow any paraphernalia, including magazines, pictures of drawing, clothing, or graffiti. Communication is the key. Do not talk at, but with your child about pro-social activities and the dangers and consequences associated with gangs. Listen to what they have to say and value what they have to say, and encourage them to discuss all problems. Encourage students to get involved in after-school programs. Develop activities that youth may become involved with at schools and at other community centers. And as you can see, when children are involved in pro-social activities, such as after-school programs, whether it's at the church or at the school or with the Boys and Girls Club, there's also the YMCA, there's also the Phillies program and the baseball. But tap into what resources are available in the community that kids can get involved in. Know that kids that are more involved in pro-social activities are less likely to be involved in gangs and gang activity. And of course, if there's more information, you're welcome to contact me. Again, my name is Yvonne Stroman. I am the Director of Community Programs at Community Prevention Partnership of Berks County. We are located at 227 North Fifth Street in Reading, Pennsylvania. My phone number is 610-376-6988. We have a website at www.communitypreventionpartnership.org. You're more than welcome to tap into our website and find out more information. We are willing to come out to your community and present to you this slide presentation in more fuller detail. We have had the capability and ability to do slide presentations. We've been out throughout the city of Reading, but we're willing to come out and present it to parents, to schools, to community folks, to churches, not just in the city of Reading, but also in the greater Berks County. Gangs are noted in throughout the community, and it's our responsibility to bring this information to you to raise your level of awareness. We hope that you will call in this evening if you are a home viewer and you have some questions that perhaps I could answer for you. Please call us. We are live at 610-378-0426. Or if you would like to give us more of a call at Community Prevention Partnership, our number is 610-376-6988. I recognize I went through this PowerPoint presentation rather quickly. I wanted to be able to make sure that I went over all those slides within the time period that we have. So I do encourage home viewers, if you're out there that you wish to call. We have about 5 more minutes left. If you will allow me to just to kind of recap some of the information that I have gone over with you. The objective for tonight was to increase your knowledge as a home viewer about youth, about gangs, and some of those things that put youth at risk to become involved in gangs. Gangs have been noted throughout the United States, as well as the state of Pennsylvania, and more specifically the county of Berks. There are a number of noted gangs, nationally known gangs, that are here in the county of Berks, such as the Latin Kings, such as the MS-13, such as the Crips, and they have been formed and are forming, and they are targeting your young people as young as 13 and 14 years old to embrace in their illegal activities. Again, wanted to bring to you what does constitute a gang. There's a misnomer that kids, if they are traveling in packs of 3 to 5 youth and they're dressed in white t-shirts and they're all wearing jeans and they're all wearing white sneakers, that they might be involved in a gang. And the reality is, what separates that group of teens from another group of teens is the illegal activity. If you find that there are a number of youth that are traveling in your community and they are engaging in some type of illegal activity, such as breaking into cars or stealing out of homes, they might be classified as what is known as a gang. But if they're out there and they're at the playground and they're playing a pickup game of basketball and they're really just getting together out of the goodness of wanting something positive to do in their community, and they wish to just be in some type of proactivity environment, then they're not necessarily involved in a gang. So I wanted to bring that information to you in terms of what constitutes a gang member versus what doesn't constitute a gang member, so you have that basic knowledge. Gang members are as young as 13, 12 years old, according to our student surveys, but they may be even older. And how youth get involved in gangs could be that they are born into it by virtue of their father or mother being a gang member, or they could be jumped into a gang, which means that they are being beaten into a gang as a means of showing how tough you are. Or it might be a neighborhood norm, as I had indicated in some of the earlier PowerPoint slides. There might be a designated neighborhood whereby they say that they are a crew, the Hudson Street crew, and they have gang membership in that particular area. So it could be the neighborhood. But there are many, many indicators that there might be a gang in your neighborhood, and I would encourage you to get involved or to touch base with your local law enforcement to determine if there actually is gang activity in your area. We have a couple more minutes remaining. If there are any questions that I could answer for you in terms of gang involvement and what constitutes youth being involved in gang, you're welcome to give us a call, 610-378-0426. Also know that our research indicates that when youth are more involved in pro-social activities, more positive efforts, then they're less likely to get involved in gang. And parents, you at home as a parent or guardian or even as an adult, you hold the key to whether that young person gets involved in that gang or not. So I'm encouraging and challenging each and every one of us as an adult to become involved positively in that young child's life so that they're less likely to become involved in gang. They're less likely to become engaged in unhealthy behaviors such as alcohol, tobacco, and other drug use. And that they're more likely to become involved in pro-social activities such as sports, such as music, such as after-school activities in their neighborhoods. Again, my name is Yvonne Stroman. I brought this information to you as a means of gaining some awareness. We hope that you have a good night. My time is up. And please, welcome to give us a call. Thank you.